Friends, and welcome to another painting stream. Hey, how's everybody doing today? I'm Andrew, also known here in the internet as Tanatos, and this is my painting stream where I go online in the mornings and I put paints on Minnie's Good Morning Lobster of Revenge. So this might possibly be the last week that I am working on these Black Templar. That I've been working on for the last month or so. Almost exactly a month by the, I believe I started on the 14th of December, 11th or 14th, and today is the 11th of January. So yeah, about a month working on these fellows, and they are very, very close to done. I just have to do a little bit more detailing on them. My goal for today, I have four figures that still need some silver applied to them, so we're gonna do that. And if I finish with that, we're gonna work on shoulder blades or shoulder pads a little bit. And then all they really need is a little bit of work on the bases. I think, and like a wash and some snow texture. And then it's just edges. So yeah, we are really, really close with these folks. Let's hop over to Zoom Cam. Sorry, my Zoom Cam is all askew. There we go. There we are on Zoom Cam. Welcome. I'm gonna send out a tweet because I didn't do that.
Thank you.
that worked. I sent a tweet, but Twitter is being weird with its preview there, so I don't know if it worked or not. Who knows? Who knows? Anyhow. It's the morning. I am here, and we're gonna do some painting. So first things first. I bought myself new paint, and I don't know if this is what I was looking for. So let's take a look at this. So for the silver detailing, what I have been using is one of the old paints that I got from a paint kit. It's a Vallejo or Army Painter, but it's one of the named ones, not one of the numbered ones. Where is it? Called Gunmetal. Man, now I've lost. You folks have no idea how cluttered my workspace is. And I've lost my paint. Well, that's okay, because I bought new paint. Because last time I used it, I noticed it was getting low. And I was like, well, if this is going to get this low, I really should get myself a replacement bottle. But I didn't have the exact same. So what I have now is Gunmetal Gray, paint number 863 from Vallejo. And we're going to see if that's the same as the silver I've been using, which is just called Gunmetal. Looks similar. It's a little darker, I think. Maybe? I honestly can't tell. Only way to know is to start applying it to... Oh, that's sad. Chat, check this brush out. This is my medium shade brush. The brush is gone. So, my goal for today is to do what I did with this. Oh, this fellow still needs silver on the inside of his shield. But you can see I've got a silver coat on, like, the bottom of his holster. I've done some on his knee, some little specks on his shield and stuff. Some areas of his backpack. All of those are done in silver. So my goal today is to do that for the other four blade guards that I have not gotten to that stage on yet. So we'll see if I can get that to work. Oak, you say your workspace is more cluttered? Well, I believe you. I've posted pictures of mine. I don't know if I posted it to my Discord, but I posted a panorama to Facebook and Instagram. And, yeah, it's not ideal. Noticing a couple of areas where I dinged up the black on his armor. Sort of correct. It's a little bit of black surface primer out. Also, good to see you, Oak. How are you doing this lovely morning? Here in the greater Boston, Massachusetts area where I am, it is cold. So cold that Boston called off school classes today. And considering that they have not called off classes for an ongoing pandemic, the the fact that they've called off classes for cold should say something. It's actually not that cold. It's the coldest day the Boston area has seen in, I believe, 3 years. But that's not saying much. We've had a bunch of very mild winters because global warming, of course. But when wind chill is taken into account, and people always like to talk about wind chill, it's supposedly like 11 below. That's Fahrenheit. 11 below in centigrade is not that frightening. But 11 below Fahrenheit is... I can't do the math in my head. In centigrade, it's probably about 15 degrees, something like that. 15, 20 degrees. It's cold out there. Well below freezing. So, uncomfortable. No, what am I doing? Centigrade's the other way. Dang it, brain. It's too early. Alright. Touched up that little bit of surface area where I had done things wrong. Minus 24 centigrade. Yeah. Yeah. Cold. Now, right away, I can see that this gunmetal gray, it's the right shade. It's the same sort of silver, but it's much thicker than the paint I have been using. I'm going to start on his knee here. Just to sort of get an idea for how this is going to look. It's a little more blue than the silver I have been using. It's very shiny. An interesting shade. It's not exactly the same. It's a slightly darker. Here you can see this is the old silver there. And this is the new silver. Slightly bluer shade, and it's got more flecks in it. I like it, but I'm not going to use it for this purpose. I'm going to try and use up my old bottle, which means I have to find it. Okay, give me a sec here, chat. Is it behind stuff? Yeah. I don't know where I would have put it. I used it the last time I was painting, right? Something away before I'm done using it. Well, that's gonna bug me, chat. Oh, I found it. I knocked it on the floor. That makes perfect sense. I got it. I can reach it. Okay. Good. Gunmetal. Keeping contained to the probably use this bottle up, finishing up this squad. It's a very similar shade, but it's not exactly the same. And I feel it would do a disservice to have the model not exactly the same as the recipe. Anyhow, let's work on some of these details here. Paint on the brush. So I'm trying to make plans for projects I'd like to do in 22. There's a lot of painting that I'd like to try. And there's some techniques that I want to attempt to work on. So I'm sort of making plans for the year, not solid like this is everything I'm going to paint, but some sort of vague plans. I'm definitely going to be doing more Black Templar, just because having started a Black Templar army for the person that I'm painting this for, I feel it would be rude to give him these six figures and say, well, for the remainder of your army, you're on your own. And because they're fun to paint. I've definitely been having a good time painting these fellas. I will definitely be doing more Black Templar at some point. But I don't want to get burned out on them. My fear is if I dive straight into another Black Templar project, I'll get to a point where I'm like, I never want to paint Black Templars again. So I'm sort of thinking about some of the other things I'd like to work on. Amongst the projects that I have planned out, but and have even bought some of the pieces for, but I'm not super confident in my ability to do them. I want to do a Marvel Crisis Protocol diorama. Several of the plans that I have vaguely made for 22 are dioramas. I want to do a Black Panther diorama, and that's going to involve painting a background for the diorama, and building the set. It will involve building a tree, which is definitely something I've never tried before, something I'm looking forward to. Sculpting and construction, not my forte, so anything I can do to practice that is good. So yeah, I've got that Black Panther diorama that I want to do. I have another diorama I have vaguely planned. I bought a set of D&D minis that are basically four fae figures, each of which represents a different season. I can't remember what they're called. Maybe they're Eldari? But there's like a winter one, a summer one, a spring one, and a fall one. and I want to build a 360-degree set for them, where each side, it's got like a central tree, and each side of the tree is a different season, with a little elf standing on a bridge below it. So that's going to mean manufacturing the tree, manufacturing four little bridges that the elves can stand on, and then doing a whole bunch of painting, obviously. That's probably a project that'll take a couple of months. But it'll be a nice little set piece to add to my collection. And I've recently started planning another diorama. I've been wanting for a while to paint some of the Warhammer, the Age of Sigmar vampires. And I recently purchased a couple of pieces to use in building a vampire set. WizKids does, actually I don't know if it's WizKids. But there's a scenery collection of minis, unpainted scenery, and they recently released a sort of medieval hallway collection, and it's got mirrors and a sort of tapestry banner. So my plan is to build a minimalist sort of medieval hall, maybe a couple of pillars and an arch or something, and hang this tapestry and maybe a mirror or two. And practice some ridiculous freehanding. Now, I have said in the past, several times, that drawing, freehanding, all of that is not something I'm super comfortable with. So this would be an opportunity for me to try and really push myself. When working on the tapestry, I can sort of try to paint a scene onto it of some sort, which I think would be a lot of fun and enormously challenging. And then my idea for the mirrors is to paint sort of a vague approximation of the clothes that the vampires are wearing, but not the vampires themselves into the mirrors. So you get the illusion of seeing the clothes reflected, but not the vampires. So I think that would be entertaining to paint, and if I manage to pull it off, an amusing sort of scene to look at. And finally, there's a couple of like one-off figures I want to paint. I want to do something, I don't know, I've been thinking about doing some Age of Sigmar lizard folk, just because I love the sort of Mayan flair that a lot of them have, and I want to do something with the sort of gold and green, opal look. It's just a color scheme that appeals to me. So I want to do something with that. I really want to paint one of the new orcs with the squigasaurs. Those things look amazing to paint. And I want to paint I want to try doing some Tyranids. I want to try doing a beetle shimmer to a Tyranid carapace. So find a Tyranid that has a lot of sort of carapace elements to it. Tyranids, lobster, if you're not familiar with them, are space bugs. Think the bugs from Starship Troopers. They're sort of that sort of thing. Come in waves. But they're not all bug. They have a fleshy humanoid aspect to them as well. But I want to try and do that sort of beetle carapace thing. Do you want to know more? No, absolutely. I do not want to know more about Tyranids. Do not. Anyways. Yeah, Nids are disgusting. And I really want to try and paint a couple. And what else? I want to do some Ioneth Deepkin, which are another Age of Sigmar army. They are evil underwater elves. And my concept for what I want to do with them is I'd like to do something with sort of a dappled underwater look, like they're in a tide pool. The thing with the Deepkin is that they hunt on land, but use their magic to make the land behave as if they're still underwater. So their aesthetic is very underwater. All underwater flowy robes and stuff. So I figured a dappled tide pool look would be appropriate, and it would be an amazing challenge to paint. Like, I can conceive of it in my head, I can picture it, and the action of moving that picture from my head to a physical reality on a mini be an enormous challenge, because it would involve just gobs and gobs of shading. I think that would be one of the first projects I would attempt if I get myself an airbrush, which is one of my ambitions for this year, is to get myself an airbrush to work with. And I can really experiment with blending, shading, slightly faster painting application. Anyways, those are my current sort of back burner projects that I have in my head that I would like to do in 2022. We'll see how many of them I actually get to. It's going to be a lot of painting, friends. I think 2022 2022 is going to be a year full of painting for me. Excuse me, coffee burp. Also, pondering doing some commission work just for the variety, because it gives me a chance to try and really push myself doing some armies that I'm not familiar with. And I'm going to do some Tau. My first Warhammer 40k army was Tau. I have a bunch of unpainted Tau lying around my workspace here. I'm going to get back to them, chat. Back in 2020, I started work on some Tau when I was trying to figure out how to kill time during lockdown. And I'd like to return to some of those. And I have several other Tau lying around. And of course, we're getting a new codex and start collecting box within the next few weeks. So there's lots of Tau to paint. Ooh, Oak, I'd love to hear about the diorama that you're planning. Some parts of this wall where the spray-on primer didn't quite get there. Now, Oak, I was saying I would like to hear about the diorama that you have planned, because you mentioned that you're planning to do a diorama yourself. This shoulder blade needs a lot of work. That's going to be an entire stream to itself. Probably tomorrow I'll work on shoulder blades for a bunch of these folks. Delicate with the front of the figure here, because it really is an area that the eye is just drawn instantly to. So I want to make sure I don't do it too messy. If I was doing non-metallic metal, this is where I would have probably spent a considerable amount of my energies. So, I don't know, it feels a little like cheating to do this with just a simple metallic paint, but got other stuff to do. I can't do these guys forever. Okay. So Oak says, you bought a tech marine. What I want to do is create a layered diorama which depicts the defense of a manufactorium on a world besieged by Necrons. I want to have a walkway over the ruins of the factory floor, which is flooded and has the ongoing fight between the Necron warriors and Skitarii, while the tech marine is on the catwalk fighting the Necron lord. That is so much work. That sounds spectacular. I've seen in painting competitions at my workplace, I have seen several marines versus Tyranid, but I don't think, because for a while Necrons were kind of abandoned until 9th edition came out and suddenly Necrons were a thing again. People hadn't been painting Necrons for the last few years. Although it's funny, my boss, the owner of the game store I work at, famously owns an unpainted Necron army that he has been working on for 2 decades now. It's a running gag in the store. How are your Necrons doing, Derek? What progress have you made on your Necrons? Oh well. Okay, let's ban this bot. I don't suppose Amanda is in chat. Sorry, I can do it. Sorry about that, chat. Don't realize how much trim these characters have until you decide to spend a day working on it. In my mind, this was a relatively fast, easy process. I was like, there's not much silver I have to do. It's like some bits on the backpack, and his knee, and his chest. But as soon as I get into it, I'm like, man, there is so much detail here to do. And some of it requires a little bit of precision, because I'm trying not to paint into the areas that I've already primed or I'm keeping black. No, I really appreciate that, Oak, the idea of your diorama being very much storytelling. All my dioramas that I have planned are just artistic endeavors for myself, a way to push myself as an artist and do new things with modeling and painting. And your diorama plan sounds very much like an encapsulated piece of fiction. Just the moment captured in minis. And that's an awesome, awesome thing to aspire to do. just thinking about the pieces involved in the mini, I say mini, this thing is probably going to end up being like 3 feet by 3 feet. Just, you're basically painting three squads. Or I guess you're painting a tech marine, you're painting the Necrons, you're painting a Necron Lord, which is a project all unto itself. And then the entire Manufactorium set that you're going to be doing is a major undertaking by itself. Having done some terrain in the last year, I will say I desperately need an airbrush before I return to terrain painting. It's just so time consuming, and there's so much surface area to cover. And the level of detail that I try to get into things when working on terrain, it became somewhat repetitive and oppressive to me. I reached a point where I was like, God, I do not want to do any more terrain, but I haven't finished the terrain that I've started. I still have a bunch of kill team terrain sitting in a box behind me here that I need to finish someday so that I can bring it into the store so that people can use it for battles. Of all the things I've painted, that is the piece that is most likely to get used in the store. Are those larger terrain pieces, because we just always need terrain. Folks always need that stuff to work with. And I just can't motivate myself to get back to it because it's so exhausting. Alright, what do I still need to do? I still need to do his scabbard, and I still need to do the backside of his shield. So I'm going to get myself an airbrush this year. That is definitely on my 2022 list. I'm going to get myself an airbrush. And then the question is, how do I stream airbrushing? For one thing, when using an airbrush, it's just a less precise tool than a small paintbrush. You can, you know, do some very fine work with an airbrush, but a lot of the time you're going to be spraying and paint is going to be getting past the model and all over things, which is fine. I have sort of a backdrop that I use here, which will work with an airbrush. Another thing to consider is it, by its very nature, aerosolizes the paint, and you don't want to be breathing paint. It's just not recommended. So I'd probably have to be masked while painting with the airbrush, which would mean for a very muffled voice on the stream. And another thing to consider is, depending on the airbrush, some of them have, I mean, they all have a compressor, right? Which is an engine that loads air into the airbrush to spray the paint out with. but some of them you can run the compressor prior to painting and it pressurizes a cylinder. And some of them require the airflow to be happening live. And those compressors, A, make a lot of noise, and B, require a lot of ventilation. Well, I guess the painting requires a lot of ventilation. Like I said, I'd probably be masked while doing it. I don't know. The fact of the matter is, I might not be able to stream myself painting with the airbrush when I get one. I might have to, I could pre-record segments and then talk over them. I don't know. For the purposes of my painting ability, I feel like an airbrush is a necessity. But for the purposes of my stream, it might be an impediment. So, we'll see what we see as the year proceeds. Put the compressor in the kitchen and have a long hose. Sure. I don't think that would work. It would put a lot more strain on the compressor, I think. No, I think I would opt for something where I sort of charge the airbrush by running the compressor first. So that I don't have the ka-chunk, 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 ka-chunk of the compressor while painting. Of course, that would mean I would have limited time available with the airbrush itself, because it would only last as long as it had pressure in the cylinder. I don't know how much time you get out of those things once you've loaded them up. Something to research. I'd also have to invest in air paint medium and air paints, because the paints that you use in a airbrush are much more, they're much thinner than regular brush-on paints. Like if you just put brush on paint into an airbrush, you'd clog the nozzle almost instantly and kill the airbrush. So you need to thin your paints in advance, or use paints specifically formulated for an airbrush, which would mean buying a whole lot more paint. Which is fine. Added expense. Almost done painting the silver highlights on this one figure. Oh my goodness. Chat, how long have I been live? I've been live for almost an hour, and I'm not even done with one figure. Oh well. It's okay. It's not a race. I kind of want to to be able to finish these so that I can get them to the person that I'm doing them for. Because I'm doing these as an extra life reward. And I'd like to get them done. But I also have a certain level of detail. Oh no! Just smooched paint all over the place there. I have a certain level of detail that I am attempting to achieve. And that requires time. Not a fast painter, chat. I am not fast. But I am pretty proud of what we've been able to accomplish on these folks so far. Good morning, Jen. I am doing well, thank you so much. Pleased to have you lurking. I hope work is going well. Last I saw you were doing, what do you call them? The sort of page holders that you've been doing? They're, chat, if you haven't seen them, Jen has been doing these sort of wooden wedges that you can use to hold the pages of a book that you're reading open with a lot less pressure. Basically, it's like a wedge that you hold on your thumb that you can put into the book to hold it open. They look like a handy gadget. Useful for people who need a little assistance in holding a book open. So I saw you were working on a batch of those. So that, chat, that is all silver detail, except for the inside of his shield. So let's do that quickly. And then we'll move on to a second figure. Oh my goodness, I've got five to do, and it's taken me an entire hour to do one. This is gonna be time consuming, I can tell. With time, chat, I feel like I am getting slightly faster in some of my painting. It just takes practice, but it still takes a lot of effort to do some of these details. Glad that I've, for the most part, limited myself to these two-hour streaming blocks, because I do go a little cross-eyed staring at a mini this close for this long. There's a little bit of eye strain. Thank you. I had been building these minis, not just painting pre-built minis that were provided to me, this is one of the things I definitely would have done differently. These shields are just such large surfaces. I definitely would have painted them separate from the minis before assembly, so that I could get the inside of the shield and I could get that side of the figure as well. It's just tricky work painting the shield after it's been glued on. Not complaining. Just saying, I would have done it differently. Interesting to me how an artificial thing like the end of a year and the start of a new one can lead to so much introspection and planning. Like, I put together a video, posted it online, of all the minis that I painted in the year 2021. So it was sort of a year in review thing going on there. And then, you know, I'm thinking a lot about planning my projects for 2022. I guess it's helpful to have that sort of benchmark. I wonder if there's a biological component to that. That we have harvest festivals, right? And solstice festivals. Celebrations of various points of the season, and it's all related to how the tilt of our planet on its axis affects the length of days for those further from the equator over the course of a year. And I wonder if that gets built into our biology and our physiology. And we have a biological need as the seasons change to think about or to pause to plan. Wouldn't surprise me if there's a biological component to it. On the other hand, humans evolved, I believe, in a fairly equatorial climate, so there probably were not seasons as we further from the equator know them for our hominid ancestors. So I think it's largely an artificial thing. It's a result of record keeping in calendars. Almost done with the inside of his shield. He's got these power nodes here as well. So we'll get some paint on those, but I'm not being overly precise with them because I don't anticipate anybody spending a lot of time looking at the back side of his shield. And I have to do the power node on his sword because I haven't done that yet. Then we'll start work on another figure. At this rate, I'm definitely not going to finish these guys this week. There's just too many of them. Big difference going from doing Bellicor and Bastion Carthalos, which are single pieces. I mean, Bellicor obviously was an entire month on his own, because he was a big thing to paint. But it's a big contrast going from single units to doing a squad. Can't even imagine doing an entire army. Just have to break it down, you know? You can't think about the size of the army you're painting. You have to think about each squad or unit individually. That's like my Tau. They just never end. So much Tau. Actually, I had somebody at the store who had some spare Tau, or had some Tau he intended to paint and never got to, and he was like, "You play Tau, right? Here, I'll give you these." And boom, I suddenly had a whole bunch of extra work to do. Alright, that's all the trim on this fellow. Whew, that was a lot of work. It's okay. He's looking good. I'm quite happy with him. This guy, I think... Oh, hang on. I didn't do his sword. Design on his cuff of his armor here. Do that in silver. targets here. That up. Oh, wow. Should I do the gold on his sword? I think I'm going to leave that for later. That's sort of the next step. I should be able to do all of the units in this squad quite quickly. It's just one area that requires a little bit of gold. All the silver trim on him complete. Took a little while, but that's fine. One side. I have another unit that I did some silver work on. Did I finish it all? I think I did. Oh, I didn't do the inside of this shield. Let's do the inside of this guy's shield. Mostly done. No point to turn and tail, there's no escaping our attack. Yo ho, yo ho, we roll beneath the black. Do some work on these purity seals here. Yo ho, yo ho, we roll beneath the black flag. A rollick and we go, we breathe the kingdom's dry. That it could be text. Our steel is ready and our retribution is severe. We plunder from the greedy with blood and with thirsty. I don't know how well that's doing that. The holy ocean's mysteries, the tales of ancient deeds. We follow in the delicate balance on the brush. As well. His only purity seal? Yeah. Okay. His fellow needs silver on his sword here. Quite happy with the lightning pattern that we got onto these swords. Many moons I've lingered lonely, tell you, chat, painting is so much about just patience and taking time, and there's going to be areas that are repetitive, and you can't let it get you down. A lot of just doing the same sort of things over and over again if you're working on minis. It's also part of the appeal, right? Because the whole thing is taking time out of your day, and having some quiet time, and doing something that doesn't involve rushing or trying to complete a task super fast. It doesn't involve a great deal of efficiency. An opportunity to just sit quietly and work on something. It's a very peaceful, meditative activity. But especially when you're doing a squad like this, there's going to be times where it feels somewhat repetitive. And that's okay for me. I hope it doesn't make my stream boring. Like, oh, he's painting shields again. I think I'm going to be able to finish a third unit today, like in terms of just the silver trim, but we can certainly start a third unit today. And then maybe on Friday, when we get to finishing Friday, finish three units this week, leaving me with two units to go for next week. To me, because these are areas that are very much inside the model, so to speak, not areas that are going to be scrutinized by anybody, really. else to do in here. And on to our third individual of the day. Sorta. I think that's all the silver bits on him. His shoulder pads need a lot of work. So maybe tomorrow is all about shoulder pads. Most thrilling stream of all time, but I definitely need to get some work done. This border here between the black armor and the white shoulder pad is not very precise. Oh well. Really want some good clean lines here. How much time do I have left in today? Half an hour? Let's see what we can do. On to figure number three for the day.
To
folks need wash. And I wonder if I should do that today as well. Right. Noticing areas where I leapt paint on areas that I wanted to keep black. So I have to go in and add a little black in to make the edges sharper. Like right here. Purity seal. Oh, gracious, that was a big blep. Perfectly fine, Chad. It's so weirdly relaxing to paint skulls. Or, it's just, it's strangely satisfying. When I'm done with all these black Templar, well, I'm going to finish those two blood angels that I was working on. And then I think I'm going to try and do some non-metallic metal practice, because that's something I really need to work on. It's something I want to have in my repertoire. Something that requires a lot of precision and practice. So I think that's what I'm going to do in the short term. Finish these last five figures that I'm working on. Deliver them to the person I'm painting them for. two figures I've already started work on. There's a whole area of the model right here that got no primer when I was priming these guys. One problem with this paint, using this black, it's very thin. As I can, just to do justice to the sculpt. I spend a lot of time doing belt buckles, rivets, little skulls here and there. Thing about assembly lighting is when you finish one model and move immediately to the next, you have a better sense for what details you want to work on. So you have in your head, like, I know I did this on that model I just finished, so I know what I'm going to be doing on this model. Thank you. yourself be intimidated by the amount that you have left to do. You just have to break it down into the pieces that you need to paint and start working on them. Like, if I let myself dwell on how much I haven't painted yet, I'll never get it done. But once I sit down, and I have a vague sort of plan, I'm like, I'm gonna do all the silver. Then it's just a matter of finding the silver bits that I want to do, and getting the paint on them. And sure, it's time consuming, and sure, there's a lot to do, but it gets easier. The hardest part sometimes is just sitting down and getting started. I did not do a very good job climbing this guy. I keep finding bare plastic. Well, this is awkward chat. I have a tree branch in my way. Man. Okay, that was messy. It's okay. It's all fine. Left in today's stream, so I'm not going to finish all the detail on this guy, but I'm going to make some progress. Like, I think all that will remain for him is the back of his shield. We'll get these little details on his backpack done today. We'll get his halo there. I think I might finish today doing a bit of a wash on this guy and the one I just did some detail work on. There's a couple of areas where they look kind of plain, and a quick wash will give them a little bit more character. Tomorrow, will work on shoulder pads and the hilts of their swords. That will probably take up most of tomorrow. I don't know if I'll stream on Thursday or not. And then Friday, for finishing Friday, we'll do edges on these fellas. And the insignia on the shoulder pads. So, we'll get two or three models done this week, leaving us with two or three for next week, and then we'll be done with this squad of Black Templars. And we'll move on to other stuff. Definitely a nice way to start the year, finishing off this little squad. And I am very much looking forward to the remainder of 2022. See what this year brings, both for my stream and for everything else. I hope that everybody out there is going to have a wonderful year. Do lots of art. Take care of yourselves and friends and family. We all know this is a scary time. But we can get through it. If we all work together. Finish this backpack here. We'll call it for today's stream. I can feel myself hurrying, and I know that that's making for less precision. I hope everybody had fun today. Hope you're all going to have a lovely Tuesday. If you're in the Boston area, stay warm. Put on extra layers if you're going outside. Don't leave any skin exposed to the wind. It's one occasion where wearing a mask actually feels quite comfortable. outside and your face doesn't immediately freeze right up. Hopefully condensation on the inside of my mask doesn't freeze. We'll see. I'm not spending a lot of time outside. Pretty much just going outside and going straight to my car. And then going from my car straight to the store. I feel bad for anybody who does have to spend a lot of time outside today. Because there are people who do have to spend a lot of time outside. I hope they're taking some extra efforts to stay warm in this, the coldest day that we've had in the last 2 or 3 years. I do have time, after I finish this halo, to do a quick wash. I didn't get to the back of his shield, but I think I got everything else on this character. So I call that progress. Take a little time tomorrow to finish the inside of his shield, and then we'll have 3 figures with all the silver detail done. Cool. Progress. Fix up his knee a little bit. Quick brown wash on a couple of these folks. An entire day doing nothing but silver. We're using Agrax Earthshade. Thank you, Lobster. 22 bits for 2022, I guess? But yes, another day's progress. Such a difference, and it's so easy to do. always has such a big impact on the model. I love it. And we gotta get the ground at his feet and the back of his robe here. The terrain, I just slather the wash on, not being at all conservative here, just dumping it on. This is why I go through the Agrax Earthshade so quickly, because you really want to get it just into the cracks and crevices of the terrain. Adding some snow to this as well at a later date. By which I mean on Friday. For finishing Friday, we'll add a little bit of snow to this terrain. Paint the little twig here. I was going to do a wash on one more figure, but I appear to have run out of time. So chat, I'm just going to say thank you, as always, so much for being here. Such a pleasure to have you folks hang out with me while I get some more painting done. I am, at heart, a very lazy person, and it helps me enormously to know that you're going to be here to keep me company. So thanks for being here. Stay safe and warm, everybody. And I will see you tomorrow, when we'll work on more details on these figures. Every day a little bit of progress. Oh, my back. Have a wonderful remainder of your day, chat. We made good progress. Didn't feel like it, but definitely there is more paint on these models today than there was yesterday, and that is all you can really hope for. Be excellent to each other, friends, and enjoy whatever art it is you choose to do. I'll see you tomorrow. Bye, everybody.